Hey guys, what's up? I'm Nikhil from dopemotions.com and welcome to this brand new After Effects tutorial. So few days back I was just browsing through the web, going through the videohive.net website, seeing some really cool artwork by some really amazing people, and that is when I came across this template, After Effects template called Typography by The Realist, by the author name The Realist. And I saw his template called The Typography, which has a really unique style, and it has this really cool text animation which has its own flavor to it and looks pretty nice, intricate. So I thought of recreating it in After Effects, and it was really simple to come up with, so I thought of sharing it with you guys. It's really nice, simple, but looks pretty cool. So yeah, with that said, let's get straight into the video and let's see how to create this style. As you can see, it looks pretty cool, right? Yeah, so let's close this up and let's begin with the tutorial. So let's start by creating a new composition and let's rename this to main. Okay, 50 seconds looks good. 1920 to 1080, let's make this, let's go with 30 FPS, hit okay. And let's start by typing our text. So I'm gonna type in the same text that I typed right over here, that is, the typography is an art of arranging type. So let's select the text tool. I will be using the Geomanist font, which is a really cool text when it comes to typography. So I'm going to type in my text. So there we go, there we have our text. Let's align this in the center. So once we are done with the text, what I can do is, let's go right over here and add a position for our animate. And then what I'm going to do is, let's go into the animator. Let's go into actually more options, range selector and advanced, so we can see all the properties right over here. All right, so the first thing let's do is change the shape from square to ramp up. And increase the easy high and easy low to 100, just like that. And for the position, that is this position, let's bring this bit down, maybe let's go with 200 for now, we can tweak it later on. And then let's go and change the mode, or not the mode, the base on, from character to words, and let's play around with the offset now. So you can see right off the bat we get this really simple and cool looking text animation, which is really simple. So let's set this to -100 and create a keyframe. Go to 1 second and let's bring this up to 100. Then I'm gonna, let's see first of all how our text looks, and I think it's looking pretty good, but just to fix it a little bit, I'm gonna just select this and hit F9 to ease it. That is not gonna work. So I'm gonna play around with the easy low. So let's set this to something like 80, maybe 90. Yep, that is what I'm going for. But for the time, I'm gonna set this to 2 seconds. So let's go right over here and drag this keyframe. Okay, so once we have our text animation, let's select it and hit Control Shift C to pre-compose it, and let's call this text underscore 01, hit okay. And let's go into the text comp that we just created, and let's hit Control K. I've been using After Effects from a very long time and I still don't remember the shortcuts. Anyway, so let's set the height to around 200. I think that should be good enough. Yep, that looks actually good. Maybe I'll make it 300, I think. 200 is a bit too much. Something like that. Let's create a new solid. So hit Control Y on the keyboard and let's rename this to BG for background. Bring this below. And let's add a ramp to this. So I'm gonna type in ramp. There we go. For this color, I'm gonna go with kind of a red, light red color. And for this one, I'm gonna go with kind of a light orange color, which looks pretty nice. So something like that, looking pretty good. And I should have probably done this on a shape layer, but my bad. I'm gonna just scale this down a bit, just like so. Go with 50. Let's go into the main comp, and there we have our text. I think it's a bit too big, so let's bring this small make this small actually, something like that. And then let's select the composition, that is the pre-comp, and let's add a transform on this. There we go. And let's skew this up to maybe minus 10. That is too much. Minus 8. Perfect. So we have something like that, which is not looking the way we wanted it to. So let's go back into our text. Let's hit Control K and let's decrease the height of our comp. So let's keep it somewhere around there, I think. And as you can see, we still see a little text. So let's select the text, hit U so we can see the keyframes. Actually hit U two times so we can see the position. So we have two position, one is the transform position and one is the position for our rain selector. So make sure to select the position of the rain selector and bring this down a bit, just like so. Let's go into main comp and there we have it. So it's looking pretty nice. I think it's a bit slow, so let's go into the composition of the pre-comp actually of the text. Let's bring this close just like so and let's animate the square as well. So let's select the BG, create a keyframe on the scale, go back in time and let's bring this down to 0. Select the keyframes, hit F9, go to graph editor, and if your graph editor doesn't look like this, make sure to right click and click on edit speed graph. So let's select this point and drag this handle just like so. So now we have something like that. Pretty nice, looking pretty nice and snappy. Let's hit U and I'm gonna bring this bit forward in space. So yeah, this is actually looking pretty good. I'm gonna actually drag this keyframe right over here and drag this a bit closer. I think it's a bit too fast, so let's play around with the timing just to find the exact spot. And yeah, I think it's pretty nice. Let's go into main comp and let's see. I think the animation of the square is a bit too fast, so I'm gonna put it somewhere around there. Let's see. It's pretty slow. This should work. Yep, this is looking very nice. So let's go to 2 seconds and hit S to bring down the scale properties, create a keyframe. Actually, I'm gonna set this to 80. Okay, and let's go a few frames forward, maybe 15 frames, I guess, and let's set this to 90. Let's select the keyframes, hit F9, go to graph editor, and again create a peak, but this time I'm gonna create a peak in the center, just like so. So now we have this really cool animation. Now I think I should increase the size to 95, and for this I'm gonna go at 75, I think. Let's see. Yep, pretty nice. Let's go to 3 seconds, hold Alt and close bracket, then hit Control D to duplicate it, right click, go to time and time reverse layer. So we have our out animation as well. Pretty nice and simple, and I think this technique is pretty useful for creating some really cool looking, you know, animations. So to give you guys a quick example, I'm going to create one more animation pretty quick. So what we need to do is actually let's go into text and I'll just copy this up. So hit Control C. Let's create a new composition. Let's call this text 02. Hit OK and paste Control V to paste up the animation that we had. So now I'm gonna type in something like J O Y 8. Just something interesting, cause I saw actually this thing in the template by the realist. So I'm gonna use something like that. And for the comp size, I'm gonna hit Control K and let's increase the height to around, let's go with something like 600. Okay, this is looking okay to me. For the background, I'm gonna just copy the gradient ramp. So hit Control C and delete the background. Let's select the ellipse tool and I'm going to create a circle, and for the fill I'm going to go with something like a black color. We don't need any stroke. So from the center, I'm going to create a circle just like this big, put this behind and let's align this in the center just like so. But now as you can see, our animation is not lining up with the animation with the circle actually. So what I'm going to do is, let's duplicate this layer, that is the circular layer. So hit Control D to duplicate it, bring this on the top of our text, and let's change the text track mat to alpha mat. So now we have something like that, but it's still not working. So let's go right over here. Let's actually select the text and hit U so we can see the keyframe. Jump to this first keyframe and hit U two times so we can see the position property of the range selector, and just bring this down just like so. So now we have this really cool look. Also, I'm gonna animate the scaling of the circle. So let's go right over here at 1 second. Hit S, create a keyframe, go back in time, let's set this to 0. Select the keyframes, hit F9, go to graph editor, and let's create just a curve like that. So we have a really nice and simple looking animation. Then what I can do is, let's go to 1 second actually, and let's hit Control D to duplicate it, bring this below. Let's change the color so we can, you know, see it a bit more properly. Select this and let's add a stroke of maybe 30 pixels, something like that. We don't need the fill, so I'm gonna just set this to none, and let's hit Control V to paste the gradient that we copied before, and just place the color just like so. So we have this really nice look, but we're not done yet. So let's go to 2 seconds actually, and let's add a trim part for our stroke. So let's go into contents and add a trim part. You can play around with the end property. So let's set this to 100, create a keyframe on the offset as well. So let's go back in time to somewhere around there. Let's set this to 0. Let's bring this up to -180. Select the keyframes and hit F9. So now we have this really nice and simple animation. Maybe I'll drag this a bit right over here. Select the keyframes, hit F9, go to graph editor, and let's create a curve just like that. So we have something like that, which looks pretty interesting to me. Also, let's go into the main comp and let's drag in our text tool right over here. Let's place it maybe somewhere. Oh, this was looking cool as well. So I'm gonna place it somewhere around there, something like so. So let's go to 8 seconds and 15 frames. Hit S and scale this down a bit, maybe 80. Create a keyframe, go 1 second, oh not 15 frames actually, and let's set this to 95 or something. Create a keyframe, actually select the keyframes, hit F9, go to graph editor, and let's drag the handles just to, you know, create a peak just like that. This really nice effect, not an effect actually, an animation. And the same exact thing just like we did before. So hit Alt and close bracket, Control D to duplicate it, right click, time reverse layer, drag it holding shift, and there we have it. Really nice and simple. So as you see, it's a really simple animation, but it looks so, you know, nice. It has its own flavor to it, looks professional and interesting to me. So yeah, I thought of sharing it with you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, make sure to like the video, share it with your friends, and also comment down below if you learned something new today. I will reply to each and every comment, as you know. And yeah, with that said, that is a wrap for today, guys. I hope this video was helpful, and if it was, make sure to subscribe, comment, and like, and I will see you in my next video. Till then, take care. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and don't forget to stay raw, stay creative.